on the Love Game.
Please welcome the host of the Love Game, Mark Holden.
Hi, good evening. Welcome to Tuesday night's Love Game. Glad to have your company. Tonight's panel, Jackie Trent and Tony Hatch.
Hi there.
Very big pleasure to have you company. And from 2SM, Mr. Ian Grace is going to tell us who the ladies are, because first game is Ladies' Choice.
First one is Lorraine Abrahams, a shop assistant cashier with brown eyes who'd like to teach ballroom dancing. And then we have Heather Davis, a music student with brown eyes who aims to be a singer.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
Welcome to the Love Game, Lorraine.
Thanks.
Would you be kind enough to tell us about yourself?
Well, I like late nights, ballroom dancing, horse racing, sports, or anything really.
Anything. In for anything. You came on the Love Game, so you're a brave lady. How about you, Heather?
I enjoy music, drama and acting, horse riding and showing, and sometimes just taking it easy.
And you want to be a singer, did you say?
Yes.
What kind of singer?
Oh, a bit of both. I'm training classical at the moment.
So you want to be classical and maybe popular
as
well?
Yes, yes.
Best of luck with that. There's the girls. We have two guys, don't we, Ian?
Greg Prentice, a very tall, blonde agricultural student who wants to be an artist and wealthy. And Philip Murphy, a not quite so tall, mainly blonde student with blue eyes, and he wants to be a Sloan Ranger.
G'day, Greg.
Hi, Mark. How are we?
What's your story, mate?
Well, I enjoy lapidary, collecting posters, art.
Sky's the limit.
Sky's the limit. Meditation, relaxation, a whole lot of
TM
things.
Or?
TM, astral travel, reincarnation, all the works.
Okay. This man is on a higher plane. How about you, Philip?
Oh, I have very interest in horse riding, art collecting. I collect Paisley.
You collect Paisley?
And Diamantes.
And Diamantes. Collects Paisley and Diamantes. There's the guys and the girls. Four choices. I can see them. You can see them. Jackie and Tony cannot see them. They are ready, and Jackie's first.
Actually, Tony's first.
Tony's first. You're Tony's the boss, first. Are you, Tony?
I'm the boss.
I just say, Mike, you had a wonderful little mixture this evening.
And it's my love game. So, Lorraine, I understand you like horse racing. How are you as a punter? That's the betting, not the boating.
Fair. Depends on whether I get tips or not. But I win most of the time.
Sounds interesting, yes. Now, Greg.
Yes.
I understand you aren't keen on aerobics, pastels and rap dances, yet you collect something called Paisley.
Yes.
Is that like replicas of Reverend Ian Paisley or something similar?
No, not at all. Paisley goes back right through history of Asia. It's just the design. It's this. He's also got some on too. And it's, I collect Paisley, and the Paisley I collect I wear. Cravats, shirts, ties, anything.
Actually, you can't see, Tony, but they are the Paisley twins.
Yes,
Paisley twins. Paisley and Diamantes.
Fully explained, yes.
Did you know each other before?
Oh, no, we just met out in the room there.
And so this was purely by chance?
Purely by chance, yes.
He wouldn't read about it. Jackie.
They're both actually wearing similar things.
Yes.
That is absolutely amazing. That's wonderful. Heather, as well as training as a singer at the con, you also enjoy drama and acting. What sort of roles do you like?
Well, I've mainly used my acting in musical comedies, Gilbert and Sullivan's and other musical comedies. So I've done mostly comedy or pseudo-serious roles, but I like the challenge of a bit of everything.
Absolutely. Anything. Lovely, thank you. Philip. You say your ambition is to be a Sloan Ranger in England. What on earth for?
Well, I'd be a Sloan Ranger in Australia, but it hasn't really caught on here yet.
What is it? Sorry, I don't know what it is. What is a Sloan Ranger?
Actually, it's Princess Di. Her brother is a Sloan Ranger.
Well.
And they're sort of, as they call them here, Hooray Harrys.
Is that how you see it, Philip?
Well, yeah, I suppose so. It's not really Princess Di, it's more...
Her brother is a Sloan Ranger.
Yeah, Andrew, yeah. He's a Sloan Ranger, yeah.
And you want to be a Hooray Harry?
I want to be a Hooray Harry. Great. Why not?
To you, that means just having a wow of the time.
Having a wow of the time.
With lots of money.
Lots and lots and lots of
lots and lots of money.
Have you got lots and lots and lots and lots of money?
I have a little bit. Keeps me going.
But you're prepared to spend it all?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Heather, I've got to ask you, I mean, what do you think of Philip's ambition?
Well, it'd be lovely to have lots and lots of money. And I'd like to, like, be like a Sloan Ranger, but I don't know if I could be like that every day, but it'd be love to do it. I'd love to do it just once or twice, just for the fun of it.
But you'd be a lot more careful with the money.
Yes, yeah, I wouldn't be
That's how you really
blowing
are.
It.
Yeah.
But okay. It'd be lovely to have that much.
Okay. It's fun to enjoy yourself. Philip, you say you are a woman admirer. What sort of women do you admire most?
Women who enjoy raging and enjoy wearing different clothes and a bit out of the ordinary.
All right, Jackie.
As a Sloan Ranger, you want to do that. Yes, absolutely. Lorraine, it says here you want to teach ballroom dancing.
Yes.
Now, what do you actually like about ballroom? Is it the dresses or the whole ballroom dancing in general? What do you like about it?
Oh, it's the whole lot, really. It's sort of very graceful, lovely to watch and do as well. You can take out your aggravations in it as well, which is good.
In ballroom dancing?
Yeah.
Well, it depends what kind of ballroom dance you are.
I guess.
Greg, it's you seem to have a diverse range of pastimes. Actually, one hesitates to say odd. What thoughts have you got on ballroom dancing?
Ballroom dancing's great, but I just don't seem to have the patience to learn all the steps. I've done a little bit of it. We did it at school.
So, well, what have you actually got?
Hi, guys.
You've got two left feet, have you?
Oh, no. It's just that there are a whole lot of steps to remember. I quite enjoy it. It's got its place. I'd still like to see it keeping on, but...
Not
with I just haven't had the practice.
It's not your bag, in other words.
I quite enjoy it, but I just haven't had the practice.
Okay, that's it. Sorry, panel. Think about it. We'll be back. We will find out who the lady is. We will find out who the lady chooses. And there's the returning couple right after these messages.
Let's play the love game. Pen and envelope ready. All you do is list this week's 10 winning colors on the love machine on the back of an envelope, plus the dream holiday you'd like to win, and you could be flying away with the love game winners on a magical dream holiday. Keep your eyes on the Love Game every night, and after Friday's show, post your envelope to the Love Game Viewers Competition number 6, P.O. Box 197, Eastwood, New South Wales, 2122.
Hello again. Welcome back to the Love Game Ladies' Choice. Which people would you put together? Let's bring together one person, Alex Wildman, right now. Hi, Alex. You look great. Very spring and...
Yes, isn't it?
Pretty.
Looking forward to that sun. $250 the contestants are playing for tonight. Ladies' choice. We've got the guy's name in the envelope. Let's find out who the girl is.
Yes. Tony, who is the girl?
Well, it was tough, wasn't it, Jack?
It certainly was.
Very tough. Yes. But we went for Heather.
All right. Congratulations, Heather. Heather, you were listening to the guy's answers. Would you like to ask him a question to help you make up your mind?
Yes. Greg first. What would you say is your best point?
My best point? That's pretty hard to define, actually, seeing that I've got many. I'd have to say my personality.
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 Okay. And Philip?
My best point?
Yes.
I'd have to say my legs.
All right. There you go, Heather. Greg's personality or Philip's legs? Which do you want?
I think I'll take Greg.
All right, congratulations, Greg. Sorry, Philip and Lorraine. We do have a gift for you, however.
For Philip and for Lorraine, a night to remember at McMahon's Manor. Pre-dinner cocktails, a delicious three-course meal for two, and the hilarious stage show starring Tracy Lee. From McMahon's Manor at Hurstville.
How are you, Heather?
A little bit nervous.
A little bit nervous? Yeah. Oh, well. You ready for this?
Yes.
Heather? Meet Greg. How do you feel, Greg?
Oh, fine.
Fine?
Enjoying myself. Yes.
Enjoying yourself?
Sure am.
How about you, Heather?
Oh, great, thanks.
Oh. Great, thanks. All right. Let's see what we can do for you with the envelope.
Right, for Heather, first of all, we have a love chain, and for Greg, we have a heart pin courtesy of Bruce and Walsh, and for $250, the panel have chosen Greg.
All right.
Sure is.
That's pretty cool.
That's a gas.
That's a gas?
Sure is.
Sure is. Okay, we have an extra $250 for you now, and you can spend it at one of these places.
If the machine detects friendship, that's green. It's a night out at Sydney's Hilton Hotel, dining in the San Francisco Grill and dancing at Giuliano's Disco and the Supper Club. If it registers affection, that's amber. They could be off on a North Queensland holiday, 2 days and two nights on the Barrier Reef from Travelland and TAA. If it senses romance, it'll show up as blue, 3 days and nights at the Hyatt Regency Hotel Fiji on the beach, flying Air Pacific from Travelland. And if the machine senses passion, it'll register red. They could be cruising the Pacific to Fiji aboard P&O's lovely lady Oriana. It's an international hotel, a casino and much more from P&O.
Pens out if you're in the competition. Any special place you'd like to go?
Oriana.
The Oriana, we'll see what we can do. Hands on the sensor plates and let's hope for the best for Heather. And for Greg. It's moving up. It is moving up. It is moving up. It is! Oh! Whoa! Whoa! Hasn't stopped. Blue, what is it, Gracie?
It's the Hyatt Regency Hotel on the beach at Fiji.
Whoa! That's Fiji. Is that good? Is that good, Greg?
That's fantastic.
You pleased with that?
I sure am.
Well, that's $150 to $200 plus $450 as well. So you can have a great time?
Sure am.
You'll come back and tell us about your holiday?
Sure will.
Yes. You will? Okay. You will be back in a flash. I'll leave you with Alex. Meanwhile, one couple are going off to Fiji. One couple have just come back from the resort. They are Wayne and Charlene. This is their story.
Here we are at the resort at Surfers Paradise as Wayne and Charlene see the sights. Go for a paddle. Whoops, where's Charlene, Wayne? Oh, there she is. But were they made for each other? Let's find out as we welcome back Wayne and Charlene.
Hi, Charlene. Hi, Wayne. Well, were you made for each other?
No.
No.
No. Was the resort good?
Oh, yeah. It was terrific, fantastic.
Yeah, a great holiday, but... Okay, let's get to the nitty-gritty and find out. We asked Wayne and Charlene what were each other's best features, and this is what they said in private.
Best feature, I'd have to say her eyes. Every time I looked in her eyes, I sort of couldn't take my eyes off her. Just looking into her eyes are really good.
His eyes would be his best feature completely. And he's got a good build. Very good.
She was romantic, yes. Especially after we had dinner and had a few drinks and went back to the room.
He's really sexy. nice body. Just perfect, I'd say.
She didn't have a bad body, it was pretty good. Didn't get much of a chance to see it. She never had a cosies on or anything, but from what I've seen, it was pretty good.
I'd say he was my sort of guy, but I don't know, there's just something about him.
She never knocks back a drink.
His legs are really weird shaped. I don't know why, they're just funny at the top, real thin at the bottom.
And when we're together, we have a good time, but as far as being together for the rest of our lives, I just couldn't see it.
Seems to me, though, just from the tape, that there was something there, though. Or there could have been something there.
Don't know.
You don't know? You don't want to talk about it?
No.
We had a good weekend. We got on fine, but, you know, that was it.
That was it. You won't see each other again?
Oh, we'll see each other again, yeah, for sure, on a friendly basis. Yeah.
On a friendly basis. Yeah, okay. Sure. Mm-hmm. Thanks for coming back and sharing that with us, and because you did, we have a gift for you.
For Charlene, we have a beautiful fur jacket, and for Wayne, a superb leather jacket from the people with the largest and most beautiful selection of fur and leather, the people from Cornelius.
You can meet a friend, have a trip, maybe more. Four new contestants coming up after this message. Let's play the love game. Back for the love game. Glad to have your company for Guy's Choice. Who are the guys, Gracie?
The guys are Mark and Michael Langshaw, a tall driver with brown hair and green eyes, and Wayne Hogan, a storeman who likes love songs and Australian bands.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
What have you got written under there?
Cosmo.
Como?
Cosmo.
Cosmo. That's your last name?
That's my nickname.
That's your nickname? Oh, how'd you get the nickname Cosmo?
Where I work, I've got a real spacey type attitude.
Okay, what other things are about you except being spacey?
I'm a fire patrol officer of the Volunteer Bush Fire Brigade. I like adventurous life, camping, bushwalking, bit of abseiling, and
outdoors disco, kind of a guy. Yeah. All right, how about you, Wayne?
Hey, Mark, I like motor racing, I like to play soccer, I like to wine and dine, and I also enjoy women.
Enjoy women. Well, you're on the right show. We also have two women, don't we, Gracie?
We certainly do. Delphine Parker, a travel-minded secretary with green eyes and brown hair, and Melissa Thew, who also wants to travel around the world and work as a graphic designer.
Please, Delphine.
I like collecting dolphin jewellery. I like going out and having a good time. I like playing a bit of tennis and a bit of bowling and just a little bit of squash.
Okay, how about you, Melissa?
Well, I'm fairly determined and I like surfing, travelling, partying and camping.
Okay, there they are, four contestants. Jackie and Tony are ready. It's the guys' game, so it's Jackie's turn.
It is indeed. Actually, I was just thinking about this nickname Cosmo, actually. You say, actually, Michael, that they named you Cosmo at work. Do you actually know what Cosmo means?
I think it's to do with a heavenly body, sort of stars.
Yes, yes, you're worldly. Yes, I've put that about right. Delphine, you say you'd like to change your attitude towards some things. Now, come on, what sort of things you'd like to change your attitude about?
Well, I'd like to change my attitude towards men because sometimes I can find that they're a bit of a pain. But I know that I can't change them, so I have to change my attitude.
Flexible lady. Tony.
Yes.
Wayne, you say that on a great night out, you'd like to wine, dine, dance and frolic. Could you explain your idea of frolic, please?
Well, that all depends on the time, the place, the lady. And how hot the blood's run.
I like it. Melissa, you enjoy partying. What do you call a good party?
Well, I work with a lot of live bands, and normally the staff get together after a good band and we just sort of party on in town or back to someone's house or something. So...
Thank you very much,
Jackie.
That certainly sounds familiar, doesn't it? Wayne, how do you like Melissa's ideas? You know, how do her ideas meet with your own on a good party?
Well, they're much the same. I like to get together with friends and enjoy the company of my friends. And also, partying is one of the greatest, more pleasurable sides of life.
Right. Yes, that sounds pretty good. Michael likes rock and roll music. How does that fit with your musical tastes, Melissa?
Pretty good. I love rock and roll.
You do?
Yeah.
Great.
Tony.
Michael, Delphine likes to be treated as a lady.
Don't we all?
Not as one of somebody's mates. Now, how do you treat a lady?
I treat every girl I meet like a lady unless they prove otherwise.
What does that mean? That's what I want to know.
A pat answer, definitely.
Yes, definitely.
And Delphine, Wayne has a weakness for what he calls feminine beauty. What is your most beautiful feature?
Well, personally, I don't really know, but friends and family have told me that I'm supposed to have sexy eyes.
The eyes have it.
I'm sure you have.
Eyes. That's it. Sorry, panel. Yeah. Think about it.
I got some lovely questions to ask that I didn't even get a chance.
Sorry, we've run out of time. We will find out who the guy is, who the guy chooses, right after these messages. We'll see you then. Welcome back, Guy's Choice, isn't it, Alex?
Guy's Choice, $250. We've got the girl's name in here. Let's find out who the guy is.
All right, Jackie, who is that guy?
Well, as we've talked about this, and the responsibility weighs heavily upon us, but we've actually chosen Wayne.
All right, congratulations, Wayne. Well, Wayne, would you like to ask Delphine and Melissa a question?
Yes, Delphine, what do you think the most important ingredients of a relationship is?
Is truth. You have to be truthful to each other or it'll never work.
And Melissa?
Sincerity, love, and affection.
All right, sincerity, love, and affection, Wayne, or truth? Delphine or Melissa? Who do you want?
Delphine.
All right, congratulations, Delphine. Melissa and Michael, we're sorry, but you will get a gift so that we can remember to see you at the Love Game.
For Michael, put some summer colour on your feet with these boat shoes. They're from Julius Marlowe. And for Melissa, this professional 1200 hairdryer and Australis Purse concentrate perfume spray.
Shaking like a leaf, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, well. Wayne? Meet Delphine. How do you feel, Delphine?
Good.
Good?
Yeah.
Happy?
Very.
How about you, Wayne?
Yeah, great.
Happy?
Yeah.
Well, let's see if we can get you even happier. The envelope, right. Please.
$250 at stake. And I've chosen Melissa, so we jackpot to $500 in the next game.
Sorry about that, guys. But you still have a lot of fantastic holidays ahead of you, like these.
They could be spending, Mark, Wayne and Delphine could be spending 2 days and nights at the heart of the Gold Coast, the resort surface paradise from Travelan and TAA. If they register affection, they could be off on a North Queensland holiday for 2 days and two nights at the Barrier Reef, Travelan and TAA as well. Now, if the machine senses romance and shoots up to blue, 3 days and nights at the Hyatt Regency Hotel Fiji on the beach, flying Air Pacific from Travelan. And if it's red and it senses passion, they could be heading for Hawaii, the superb Sheraton Surfsider Hotel on famous Waikiki Beach. That's from Viva Discovery Holidays and Travelan.
Hands on the sensor plates. Let's find out where Wayne and Delphine are going. What is it, Gracie?
It is the Gold Coast, the resort surface paradise.
Wow. All right.
We're great.
Happy with that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Happy with that, Wayne? Will you come back and tell us about it?
Yeah.
You'll be up there in the sun?
Yeah.
All right. All the best. See you down the line. Thanks, Alex.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you, Jackie.
Thank you.
Great to have your company. Thank you, Gracie. Thank you for watching. Lovers of the world, unite. See you tomorrow night. Good night, everybody. Let's play the love game. Well, when